Hi you guys, Lindsay here. Welcome back to my channel, Inside the Hem. To wrap up my series for Style Maker Fabrics Spring Style Tour 2019, I'm going to give you all the details about the Itch to Stitch Nottingham top, which I used to make this stylish sweatshirt. The website describes this top as a relaxed fit bodice with sleeve options. It's super comfy, casual knit top that looks fabulous with pants or a skirt. It features a front off-centered twisted knot, relaxed fit bodice, a scoop neck with neckband, and three sleeve options: long sleeve, elbow short sleeve, and butterfly sleeve. It is suited for beginners and comes in sizes 00 to 20, which accommodates a bust of 48 inches and hips that are 55 inches. You may notice that the sample versions on the website are much longer than mine. I noticed the length right away and knew that I would have to shorten mine for a few reasons. One, I needed to make sure the proportions would be right for me. I need to wear tops that are on the shorter side to elongate my legs. Two, I needed the top to be short enough to hit at the narrowest part of the pants. If the top hit anywhere below where the hip darts opened up, it would have just been too much volume and it would have made me look wider than I am. So, to look taller and skinnier, I shortened the top by a whopping 3 inches. And honestly, I could have shortened it more. But due to the twist front, this isn't one of those patterns that you can shorten after the fact. So I decided on 3 inches and had to stick with it. Another thing I noticed from the sample photos was that a lot of people's tops flared out a lot at the hip. I couldn't tell if this was because they widened the pattern pieces themselves or if it was drafted this way, but I knew I didn't want mine to do that. I was already shortening the top to hit me at a narrower part of my hip, so I didn't need to use my usual hip measurement. Instead, I used my high hip measurement and picked the size based on the finished measurement chart. This gave me a more fitted hip on my sweatshirt. Finally, I had to recut the sleeves altogether because, as it turns out, this pattern is drafted for a very stretchy knit, and my fleece barely had any stretch at all. So I recut them, adding a total of 2 inches to the sleeve seam. It's roomy enough to move around, but definitely not bulky or loose fitting. You may notice that I added contrast cuffs to my sleeves too. This was easy enough as I just chopped off about 4 inches of length and drafted little rectangle pattern pieces that were as long as the new wrist opening and twice as wide as I wanted the finished cuff to be. Considering that I had to learn the hard way about the sleeves, you would think I would have thought this through when making the neckband, but I guess I like to learn the really hard way. The neckband is a little too high and definitely too tight for my liking, but I left them as they were because I already cover stitched them and ain't nobody undoing cover stitching over here. I can get it over my head and I guess that's all that matters, but next time I'll be sure to consider the stretch of the fabric on this pattern. Finally, I added a little contrast triangle to the center front because I like the way that looks on ready-to-wear sweatshirts. I don't even really know how I did it. I just cut out a triangle from the bodice and then used that to draft the piece that would be inserted there. Let me know if you want a tutorial. I know this description is vague. For the fabric, I used 2 different sweatshirt fleeces from StyleMaker Fabrics. They aren't the exact same fleece, but very similar. The contrast fleece color is called Carmine, and it also comes in a gorgeous blue. The fleece I use for the main parts is called Coral, and only comes in that colorway. They were both super easy to work with and flew through my serger and cover stitch with no problems. They are so soft on the inside and feel so good against the skin. I got enough of each to make a pair of Hudson pants, so look out, Charlotte. A head-to-toe, melon-colored girl will be hitting the streets soon. Well, that's going to do it for me today. I hope you like my sweatshirt. The pattern is really great, and I'll be making more, and the fabric is a home run. If you need sweatshirt fleece for any projects, I'd strongly consider this one. StyleMaker Fabrics has dozens of sweatshirt fleeces in a variety of colors, weights, and substrates, so if these heathered ones aren't for you, check out the rest of their vast selection. Anyways, thanks for watching. I will see you all very soon. Bye!